Here we are, man. Here we are. Week 14 of the NFL 2020 season, of the New York Giants 2020 season, and we are playing for a playoff spot. Nobody except for the most optimistic of Giants fans, I do mean the most optimistic of optimistic, thought this would happen at the beginning of the season. I'm talking about, you know, week one, you know, even before week one began. Not a lot of people had this happening. Boy, am I happy that that is the case, man. It is week 14. We're matched up against the Arizona Cardinals, who are also battling for a playoff spot. The difference is the Giants currently sit at the top of the NFC East, and if they continue on this four-game win streak that they have going, they will clinch that playoff spot with the NFCs, you know, depending on their remaining four games, how these play out. And, you know, starts with the Cardinals, man. As Joe Judge said, one game at a time. It's a new challenge every week. Let's see how they're going to do in this challenge. But, man, oh, man, am I happy that the Giants are playing extremely meaningful football in December and maybe even in January months. So, as usual, first things first, let me get the injury reports out here, because this is an injury report that literally could affect the way the game goes, you know, in terms of whether or not we win or lose. Let's see how it goes. So first up, the Giants injury report. Of course, the two most important names on here, Daniel Jones, our quarterback, with his hamstring injury, he was in limited practice on Wednesday, and Blake Martinez, our middle linebacker, with his back, you know, his lower back pain, lower back sores injury, he did not practice on Wednesday. So first off, on Daniel Jones, there was a little bit of an update on him. You know, yesterday, myself along with other Giants YouTubers, we put out the content on that. He seems to be on track to start on Sunday, but at the end of the day, it looks like it might be a game time decision. I don't know. Judge might play around with the injury report a bit. Who knows? But he should be on track. Don't be surprised if they do sit him. And if they sit him, it drastically changes, of course, the way that this game can go. Now, the Giants did do fairly well with backup Colt McCoy in there against Seattle, who a lot of people, including myself, would argue Seattle is a better team than this Arizona Cardinals team. Not just because of what their record says, but because of who they have on that team and their coaching. And their record is a reflection of that. And we beat the Seahawks. We upset the Seahawks. So with Colt McCoy in there instead of DJ, it would seem that we have a fair chance against the Cardinals as well. That remains to be seen, to be honest with you. That Seahawks game was just perfect execution on everything, man. And then with Blake Martinez, his injury was also listed. It's not something too serious. He should be back against the Cardinals. I mean, unless they're just not letting us know what's happening. There really isn't that much information on it. And the only example of there being an injury with the Giants so far where it was a serious one and they didn't give us much information on it was the Devontae Freeman injury. Luckily, we found Wayne Gallman and everything worked out fine. But with Martinez, that's something where I'm not sure how much success and for how long you could have success by just continuing to rotate guys. Other names on here, Darnay Holmes, cornerback, limited practice on Wednesday. Mondre Harper, defensive back, did not practice on Wednesday. And offensive tackle Matt Peart, the right tackle of the future, did not practice on Wednesday either. Hopefully he can make it in for that game. Now going over to the Cardinals side of things, they got quite a few names on here. Devontae Campbell, inside linebacker, did not practice on Wednesday. DeAndre Hopkins, wide receiver, non-injury related, did not practice, so that means he is going to play. Jonathan Joseph, cornerback, did not practice. Demonta Peko Sr. did not practice. Jalen Thompson did not practice. Charles Washington did not practice. Lakeith Fotu, limited practice. And Rashard Lawrence, limited practice. The only notable name on here would be DeAndre Hopkins. I mean, you could kind of argue maybe Jonathan Joseph as, you know, a depth piece on that secondary, but DeAndre Hopkins, and he's not even going to be out of the game. So Arizona, I think, is going to be pretty well set going into this game here. And let's see how they match up now. So like I said earlier, I'm going to roll this back around to the quarterback situation real quick for a second. If Daniel Jones is in this game, I'm just going to be letting it known, I do think that the Giants will win this if Daniel Jones is in this game. The Cardinals have lost four of their last five games. They have not been doing too well. They're not doing too hot. They, in fact, look like they're kind of collapsing a little bit. And now I will say there is a chance, because it is the NFL, any given Sunday, there is a chance that at any time they could just somehow, some way, bounce back and find their way into the playoffs, right? The Giants' job is to make sure that doesn't happen against them. And you know what? It shouldn't. You know, just looking at these four games that they lost, they dropped one against the Rams, dropped against the Patriots, dropped against the Seahawks. They won on that Hail Mary against the Bills, and then they dropped against the Cardinals. Okay, so if a team like the Patriots could beat the Cardinals and if a team like the Giants could beat the Seahawks, which we did, we got a fair shot. So before I even head into the stats of these things like I usually do, I think that we have a really good chance of coming out with a W in this game. That being said, let's take a look at this Arizona Cardinals air raid offense. I put a quotes around that, led by Kyler Murray. Now, before I get into the stats, I think we all know, just looking at the Cardinals, both last year and this year, they're not really what we've been told the air raid offense would be. Now, granted, there are some games where they really do air this football out and they let it fly, but it's not as much as a lot of people thought, and they definitely rely on their running game quite a bit. I mean, you just look at Kyler Murray's stats throughout this season alone. So far, he has 2,987 yards in the air, 22 touchdowns in the air, and then you go and you look at his rushing stats now, where he has 665 rushing yards and 10 touchdowns there. Combine that with what I'm about to tell you guys, you can see that this is probably more of a rushing offense than a lot of people think. And because of where the Giants defense excels, I think we're going to have some good success. So the Cardinals are the 9th overall offense in the league, the 19th overall passing offense, and the 4th overall rushing offense. Like I said, a lot more rushing going on here than anything else. And I really do think this Giants defense is going to match up quite well against Arizona. Our defensive line is built to stuff the run. And, you know, over the course of this win streak and even before that, I want to say over the course of the past 5-6 weeks, we've been one of the best teams at stuffing that run. Dalvin Thomason, Dexter Lawrence, and Leonard Williams are absolute beasts on the inside. Our linebacking core has been doing pretty well with tackling. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully Martinez is back. Even if he's not there, you know, rookies like Tay Crowder is filling in the spot quite well. And then even in our secondary, we got good tacklers. Jabril Peppers comes down in blitz packages. You know, they disguise that really well. Shout out to Patrick Graham doing an amazing job. And Jabril Peppers gets pressure on the quarterback. He also sometimes slide down in a middle linebacking role as well. Like, for example, after Blake Martinez went down on Sunday against Seattle, they put Peppers in there a couple of times at the linebacker position and let him, you know, roam, which is what we've kind of wanted a little bit, because he has that build. He has that play style ability. Peppers is versatile like that. And in general, with the way this Giants defense has been performing the past couple weeks, they are playing at a very, very high level, man. I mean, last week when we went up against Seattle, don't forget now, they were a top 5 offense overall, one of the best passing offenses in the league, and not too bad in rushing either. We held them down to basically, what, 7-10 offensive points? You know what I mean? Earlier in the year, we played teams like Tampa Bay that we held down. We played teams like the Rams that we held down. Similarly built teams to the Cardinals, and especially when it comes to offensively, they are juggernauts. The only team offensively that we really let get away from us were the Cowboys, who we let get into the 30s, and the 49ers, who I think everybody agrees is just an outlier at this point. So when you get into the Giants' defensive stats now, we are the 9th overall defense in the league. The first overall defense when it comes to quarterback knockdowns. When it comes to sacks, the Giants are 8th overall in the league, of course led by that man, the big cat, Leonard Williams. And a big shout out to him, man. He's having an incredible year. He tormented Russell Wilson last week. Now, the entire Giants defense did. We got 5 sacks on him, 2.5 from Leo, half a sack from Jabal Sheard, 1 sack from Tay Crowder, 1 sack from Jabril Peppers. I do expect a similar game plan this week. And then when it comes to quarterback pressures, the Giants are pretty high there as well, at 6th overall in the league. And Arizona's actually up there as well. I think they're over there at 4th overall in the league when it comes to quarterback pressures. Continuing on with these defensive stats, when it comes to passing defense, the Giants are 18th in the league, and rushing defense 4th overall in the league. So what matters once again? Stopping the run. And you know what? I think the Giants are doing a pretty good job of that. And to be honest with you, stopping this run against the Cardinals, I think, is going to stop the pass. The reason our passing defense is ranked as low as it is, because as y'all remember, at the beginning of the season, we were one of the best. And when you use your eye test on these games, you know, you look at the amount of points we're allowing. Yeah, we're allowing quite a bit of yards through the air, but we're holding down. We're holding them down in the red zone. We have a good passing defense. It could be better. For sure, it could be better. We still need a legitimate number 2. Although Isaac Yiadom is performing well, but it's doing good. We just need to stop throwing. We need to stop Kenyon Drake, and I think we can do that. I really think we could stop Kenyon Drake. We could stop Chase Edmonds, and Chase Edmonds tore us up last year when he came to MetLife. I don't think that's going to happen again. But stopping the run, just like we did once again against Seattle, we stopped Chris Carson. We stopped that rushing game. We're going to really confuse them in the passing game, and we're going to force them to pass. And if we could hold on guys like DK Metcalf and Tyler Lockett, I got faith in the best man cover corner and one of the best overall corners in the league right now, James Bradbury, you know, head, you know, chief officer of the NYPD, New York pass defense. I got faith that he could keep down DeAndre Hopkins. And I got faith that our secondary can take care of Larry Fitzgerald, old man Fitzgerald, and Christian Kirk. Now, last year, Bradbury was matched up against DeAndre Hopkins, and he did a pretty good job. I expect him to do a pretty good job again this year. Even then, once again, what is it going to come down to? The red zone defense, because Arizona is actually second in the league when it comes to red zone offense and red zone efficiency when it comes to scoring down there. All we got to do is hold them down there. The Giants, funnily enough, are a top five defense in the red zone as well. So that's another matchup. I think we're matched up really well when it comes to what we need to stop Arizona at, right? We need to stop the run. I think we can do that. We need to stop them in the red zone. I think we can do that. And we just need to contain the pass. If we can contain the pass with Russell Wilson and his weapons, why can't we do it with the Cardinals and their weapons? And now, of course, I gotta talk about the Arizona Cardinals defense and our Giants offense, where it's gonna be a little bit of a struggle. And it's fine to me. I compared the Seahawks game a lot to the Cowboys because it's gonna be a really good battle between our defense and the opposition's offense, and not so much a great battle between our offense and the opposition's defense. Arizona, it's the same way again. It's another reason I got a little faith in this game is because we know the formula to win, right? I'm looking at Arizona's defense on paper, and you look at what they've done over the course of the last five or six games. They've allowed a lot of high scoring. They've allowed a lot of high scoring, almost always reaching around that 30-point mark. And on paper, they're just, you know, they're very average. Dare I say, maybe at some points below average. But here are the rankings from Pro Football Reference. They are currently the 14th overall defense in the league. When it comes to quarterback knockdowns, they are 10th in the league. So a nice number there. 14th in the league with sacks. And like I mentioned before, 4th in the league with pressures. Now, some of you might be looking at the numbers I just said and might be a little bit scared or a little bit worried. I would say don't be. I'm looking back at these games. The only games they managed to get some nice hits on the quarterbacks were the Patriots and the Seahawks. What do those two teams have in common? Not really the greatest of offensive lines. Right now, the Giants' offensive line is top notch, so we could hold these guys down. Andrew Thomas, he's looking like one of the best, if not the best, left tackles or offensive tackles in general out of the 2020 draft. He hasn't allowed a pressure in about two games, hasn't allowed a sack and a little bit more. Andrew Thomas is looking real good. His five-game stretch, just like the entire Giants five-game stretch, has been amazing. Shout out to that man. Cam Fleming, who I still think should be benched for Matt Peart, but all that depends on how healthy Peart is. He had a great game last week against Seattle. He graded out higher than Andrew Thomas, and we went from having the worst tackle duo in the league to having the best tackle duo in the league as of last week against the Seahawks. You talk about going from worst to first. What a flip. The inside, the offensive line performing tremendously. Of course, that's why the Wayne train has been taking off, because the offensive line has made such leaps and bounds. Wayne Gallman, the Wayne train has been going crazy. He had a great game last week. I expect them to do much of the same this week. That's why offensively the plan remains the same. Now let me finish off these rankings here. Passing defense, Arizona is 16th overall. Rushing defense, they're 22nd overall. Listen, man, we just murdered the third overall rushing defense in Seattle. This man should have a day, and I mean a day, against this Cardinals offense. Of course, the Giants offensive rankings, they're not going to look great because of, you know, over the course of the season. 30th overall. When you talk about passing, we're 29th overall. When you talk about rushing, we're 11th overall. Listen, the rankings, when it comes offensively, are going to be skewed because our offense hasn't really been anything except for like the last couple weeks. And even then, we're not a great scoring offense, but we get the yardage. We control the time possession. How do we do that? The run game. Wayne Gallman is going to have another big game. He's going to need to have another big game. Our rushing attack is going to need to succeed. The offensive line is going to create holes. I have faith that the offensive line could create holes. Especially, and a lot of this has to do with the fact of Arizona's recent performances. Arizona's recent performances are not a good sign for them. Now, like I said at the beginning of the video, they might be looking to have a comeback game or a bounce back game against somebody. It's not going to happen against the Giants, man. I don't see it happening against the Giants. Our run game alone is going to be enough to give us control of this game, especially control time possession. And then you add in the possible X factor of maybe Daniel Jones starting, and I think that puts us over the top. That's why I'm saying for this game, the Giants win. And I'm going to say 24-21, the Giants win. Now, that's the same score prediction I had for the Seattle game. It went lower than that. I'm going to stick with that score prediction. I want to see the Giants break 20 points again soon, because if we are going to make it into the playoffs, we're going to have to put up some points eventually. I want to see us get back to a nice, comfortable scoring level there. That's what I got for y'all today. Let me know what you all think. Put your thoughts down below. What do you think about this game? How do you think we match up? And are we winning? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'll catch y'all in the next one.